So we'll start a scorpion sculpt today. So it's going to be robotic with a lot of custom stamps that I've already made. So what I generally do is just start with a layer to map out the framework. It doesn't actually matter at all what brush I use, I don't think, simply because I'm just making something that will be deleted really, really quickly. It's just to lay out where I want everything to go. The resolution doesn't matter. The scale doesn't really matter. It's all about where stuff's going to go. So you can smooth it down if it helps, but as I say, it generally doesn't actually matter at all because nearly all of this will be deleted. So I'm thinking of this as the head of the scorpion. Keeping that as the baseline. Keep this as the floor. I'll do symmetrical floors at the moment, but they'll be probably asymmetrical and totally different than that, and we'll have limbs that come here, and a tail quite high and something like that. I want it to be mechanical, so just in terms of where everything goes, that will be fine. And as I say, all of that is going to be deleted anyway. So just moving it around a little bit. So yeah, it doesn't even matter if it's not on the axis at the moment, because it will be completely eradicated very, very quickly. So that'll do. That's got roughly the scale that I want. If it didn't, you can chop it up with the blades. So with cut, just whiz through and then basically just do that and scale it up and change the bits that you want and then reattach it if needed. But it's so quick and easy. Double click on this thing, I'll just use that as an eraser just to get rid of all these bits. So that's given me a bit more of a crane-like look. I wanted this to be some sort of a mechanical arm with something hanging down. So I'm fine with that now. So now I'm going to start blocking it in. So I need a new layer. So switch this back. So first of all, new layer. There we go. We can leave, I've got three layers now, but we can we just point to which is which. This is obviously layer two. That's layer one. So one and two. So we could, in fact, just merge those back together. So I've only got one layer with the deletable skeleton scorpion on it now. So that's fine. So I'm not going to do the legs till later on. So I'm just going to block out some of the base body and then start deleting some of the underlying. So we're on this new layer now. And we'll go to my custom stamps. And we'll just find one of the blocks that I use a lot. So this one. Make sure it's on the green. And then what you can do is switch it to, rather than it being just a free form brush, I can put it on a line. And I find this quite useful. I've lost my stamp there. So there we go. And that'll give me the ability to draw along this straight line, which I really like. Now, if you do it at the base resolution, you'll get this, which is horrible. Let me show you close up. Horrible and blobby. Notice that now is now back on the center line, even though the scorpion isn't, so it really isn't a worry. Well, one thing I will do on this layer is I'll hold down the stick here, switch on this side and go to metal, high roughness, leave it like that. So that thing that I've just painted is now, it's got a metal look. So how do we improve the look of that? So it's up the resolution by one. Let's try that. Let's get rid of this. See if this is any better. No, it's not. So maybe I undid that. So that a bit better. And then maybe one more. Because this isn't coming out and going into anything, I'm going to go fairly high resolution. There you go. You can see that's quite a lot better, significantly better. You can rotate this block around, which is useful, and then keep lining it up. Get it lined up perfectly. And then I'm just painting along that line. See there, that's quite rough. So a bit slower. And you can work back to fill in some of the holes if it's got too many. You'll see why I'm doing this in a minute, because I'm going to chew a lot of this back with shapes. So I'm only just putting in some sort of a base to start removing stuff from. It's all about lining it up with this. I'm using my thumb here. Okay, I could smooth it back a bit. But the important bit now is how we remove stuff. I think let's pop a few. A few more bits of detail in the top. I'm still only using one tool, and it's a very simple one that I made. Just a load of blocks, really. And now I can start removing, just with single clicks, you can start removing some interest and see if you get the shapes that you like. What I want to do is give myself some visual interest around where the arms are going to attach. So again, it leaves a bit of a mess sometimes, so you might have to clean that up. Let's just see what that does. Yeah, it's given me lots of blockiness. I think when I undid, I lost the metallic settings. So there we go. Back to metallic. So that's looking fine. Let's remove some of these from the front. You can see that removal is giving me some really nice greeble detail to start laying on top of, really. So that's looking fine. Let's lay down a better tail than that. So we'll turn this off, turn the line off. Not single, so we'll go back to settings, turn the line off. We're going to draw something that represents this tail. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit and we'll do it freehand and see what it looks like. So I'll do it really fast first of all. You can see what it looks like, so it's going to give me that sort of shape. So that's not too far off what I want, really. So let's try and get a better angle. When I say what I want, I'm not planning this as such. So some of this is, there you go, that'll do it. This gives us some nice visual interest and something to catch the light as we're starting to build this. And I now know where my, pretty much where everything's going to line up. So we'll put a couple more in here to help us locate where the arms are going to go. That's fine. And I will just freehand around here. Again, it's just improving the quality of that. And now we can turn off the base one. No, we can't, because I actually did it back on the base one all in one. So that now, there's nothing I can do about that now. That's now attached to my base. So what I'll have to do is, that's an error on my part, I'll just chew away the legs that were my line, the ones that I used to line things up. Makes no real difference again, because it's all very rough at this stage. Make sure we get rid of all of the rubbish. There we go. Don't need any of that. In fact, I don't need that now. I can go, because I know where that's going to be. But I've still got all of the areas lined up. Okay, so that's fine. So we'll now work on we'll improve the body now and start the claws. So I'll just go slightly lighter on the grey. And then I'm going to start putting in, first of all, I'll put in some joints, I think. So back to the stamps and back to some of the wheel joints. And again, we'll just double check that the resolution's high enough. which it is. Now that was a multiple click, so you must go back and put single on. So basically single will just do that, you just do one, as you can see. So that works fine. So let's start adding some of this detail. And these are the joints that allow the creature to move its claws. One joint there. I'll do another joint here. And actually, I'm gonna remove this completely. Let's do it with a block. And the reason I've done that is I want this all to be one part here, so I can pose it. I can pose the claws. So we'll just finish this end here. That's a couple of blocks, wouldn't do any harm. We'll put some piping in here now. Let's just think what we've got that we've made this week. This one's always good. This is just the generic arm. Again, these are all made inside Medium. Is that high enough for us? No, maybe I have to go higher. So you do have to be careful because it's starting to get slowing down, as you can see straight away. Because you're upping the resolution of everything on that layer, not just the things that you're going to stamp on the layer. Maybe that's higher than I thought. Nope, not too bad. So when you push the resolution up, you'll see now that that really gives us nice detail. Hopefully you can see that. Couple of these deep down inside, so it looks like the, once the resolution's up, I find it doesn't matter how many I put in there. At least on this machine that I'm using here, it doesn't seem to affect it. Now, if this was one that was coming out of Oculus Media, of the Oculus, then I might struggle here a little bit, but this is fine. I'll put a few of these in here. Again, you can see why chewing away that detail is good earlier on, because it's now giving us, you can hide stuff inside. Like in here, it's actually going inside the, there we go, inside the other bits that we sprayed in. So I'm gonna put something quite detailed on here. So that's enough for that now, I think. I need some big joints here, so let's find something. Back to some kind of joints. These are quite rough circles. I'll put some of these in. These were made with the revolve tool. And there are some better ones of this in natively in Medium, but it's nice to try and keep it as much your own stuff as you can, I think anyway. And then let's put great big wheels here. Should be where the pivot joins us for the claw, for the main claws. And put a couple of plates underneath. So he's looking good there. A bit more surface detail. Find something. A couple of these plates would be nice. And these are just shapes that I've made for this kind of job, really. Great for making this kind of surface. Intricacy. And then maybe chamfer them off a little bit. Gives us some really nice edging. Mechanical looking edging. Quite like that now. So let's put some eyes in him, some basic straightforward eyes would be nice. So in fact we'll just use a sphere for this, doesn't really matter. Might go back in and change this later with emissives. Jaws looks science fiction-y. Into detail there. Excuse me. Now let's work up the spinal area. So find something we haven't yet used. Actually, no, we'll use this first of all and just see what this looks like, if it's big enough. To put a bit more supporting detail at the back. Ready for where the tail's going to join. This doesn't look enough there. It's almost like a pit, like a set of pivots really, just to allow the tail to rotate and start bending in. And then we'll put some more, a couple more supports while I'm thinking about it. Under here, this side and this side, and then add in some nice straight on pistons. Should really have gone back to the line tool there, maybe. Want this to go all the way to the tail. Cross it over a bit. Again, great for catching the light. Lots more nice surface detail if you do this sort of stuff. Not mechanically accurate in the remote slightest, it's simply just for visual. So it looks great under there now with the piston. Going to put loads more pipes in there afterwards. So that looks fine. Now back to, I'm going to use some really odd shapes. This will take a few minutes because I don't know what this is going to look like. So I've got no line on, so I'm just going to have a quick try of what this looks like. Yeah, that's looking good. So nice and slowly. Just trying all the different shapes. I'm gonna get that almost like a cross between a spinal column and an arachnid carapace. Well, it's the back of this, it's towards the tail really, isn't it? So it's not even a carapace. I'll probably have to do individual plates. It's fine for a start. I need something along here now, which is plates, so let's find something. Or make something if it's not working. See what we've got that we've made that would be perfect for that. Trying to get the right angle to paint it from is interesting sometimes. don't know whether this will work. No, don't like it. So what I'm going to have to do, I've decided then, is make a special piece for this. So the way I've done that in the past is go to a new layer and then just make, paint in what I want for that, for this piece. So let's do, let's make it like a single carapace piece. So paint it like this. Go up a resolution, go back to single, and we're now making, there we go, that's better. Maybe go up one more. With this one block, we'll be able to make the core of what we want. And then smooth it down. It's always difficult to smooth down things there. Higher resolution. So let's try this and turn off single. Something else. Remember, this piece that I'm building is going to become a stamp, so it might be a lot smaller than this when it's finished. Oh, and now do some piping coming off it that will repeat across everything. Totally confident that this is going to work yet, so that would be the I guess a few more pieces removed and that would do it. So I'm just going to, that's the piece that I've done, so make a stamp of that and delete it, switch our boy back on. In fact, I can paint straight onto him. So let's just see what he looks like now. Get on the right layer, that helps. Yeah, this should be it now. And we'll do it one by one. We won't bother. I'll turn symmetry off as well, so we can just literally do one. That's it. That's what we wanted. And we'll just do one more thing, which is single. And we're done. So now, that's given me the look that I wanted. Because we're all lined up on the center, I can do it like this. I'm just going to make it a bit smaller. There we go. So it's given me that mechanical. In fact, it may even be worth doing it. Yeah, I can do it twice, and now I can switch symmetry back on for that. And we'll do a repeat up the side, which will give us a really nice effect. Yeah, that's it. So that under that piece helps. And there's still space underneath it, so that's going to catch a lot of light, I hope. Give us a lot of visual interest there. And then adding pipes to this is where it starts to look incredible. I hope, anyway. There we go. It's almost scorpion-like, and we'll carry on will actually come round here. Gives us what we need there. Great stuff. Now that's worked really well for this. This racking that we've got here, so I'm going to go back and do that racking even more now, which is made up of piping. We'll add in this all the way down now. Single one that goes down through the middle. There we go. Add a couple of supporting ones under here. I'm going to twist it all to get it to the right angle, as you can see. And then add maybe one more here. Cool. Pleased with that, it's got the effect that I wanted. Might have some more spines in the middle here, something like this, maybe every second one. And that'll allow me to put a pipe all the way down the middle there, or a structure of some kind. So that's nice. Of adding a bit more detail down the back, some more boxing. I definitely don't like this here, it's too much of that smaller surface. See if we can delete that. Bit there that wasn't playing how we'd want it. Great, there we go. Now I think with this one, at this stage, I'm going to put some piping in now. Normally I'd leave it a little bit later. I want to put some of the bigger piping in. Take it off single to be able to do it. So I'll put some big pipes in first. And then I'll just wrap them around with singles, thin singles. And this is very symmetrical at the minute, so I'll solve this shortly. Some piping in here. Very random stuff. But let's change the colour a tiny bit, slightly lighter to give it. I'm not really going to paint this guy. So a bit of visual interest early on with the piping. Colours would help. And then lots of piping from underneath to help. Sell this idea of mechanical interest. Organic stroke. Organic versus mechanical kind of stuff. And then what we do need definitely is this cable up here. And this cable is what connects the spine. There we go, quite like that. A bit more here. Great, so let's call it a day on that one for a moment and we'll just go back to the claws, or go on to the claws. So we'll do, I won't do symmetrical ones, so we need a new layer here. No symmetry on, and then just pop something in. Oops, symmetry is on. Pop something in for this one to start messing with. And then we'll start chewing away this one. So, higher resolution straight away. Again, don't only do the resolution when you're really sure you can cope with it, because it can destroy your models very quickly. Let's go back to our single for this. And then a claw on top of that. I think I've got a claw that we can use. I built for the purposes, or at least something similar. Whether it's big enough to be used for this, I don't know. No, it's not, so let's see if we can do something about that. That's fine. We need to put it on its own layer for a moment. So, new layer. Resolution up. So, put it on a new layer to make it. It's not going to look amazing because of this detail, but it's given me the layout that I want, which is more than adequate now. It's just laid out. And then what we'll do is we'll duplicate it, and then duplicate it and bring it in. That's fine. And then those two layers will merge them, and now go in and clean it up a little bit because it's horrible. So let's put some of these wheels in properly. Just clean up all of this mess inside here where all this piping is. Only cause problems later on if I don't clean it up now. So I'm just, the red's obviously just chewing it away. What do we need? Probably something along the lines of this. Just the mechanics that's allowing the pincers to move. Try not to get too many repeats. And then we will definitely go for, put a bit of blocking in here. Oh, let's overuse that one a bit. Let's put this big mechanical piece in here. We'll use that for drawing that arm around, that helps. maybe a similar thing around here. And now wires galore. And we'll go the other way with these wires. We'll go darker. Single off. Go, that's nice. Hydraulics, I suppose. Doesn't really matter because it's only for visual. Make it look cool, I suppose, is the thing. It doesn't have to be accurate. I do like the idea of black hydraulic hoses, though, so I think. See, that helps, the fact that I can pose it, and I might duplicate that and make a maybe even, I don't know, maybe even that one would be better as that one. We'll have a look at that, but we will for now, we'll duplicate that. Thinking of making him some kind of a saw blade, so he's alright for now there. Oops, lost our settings a little bit there. Crazy stuff on that one. And because of what I've just done, I'm going to go in asymmetrically now and add in a load of hydraulics here and then tons of them in here because I like that pull and I want it to be consistent. Just love how that the asymmetry, even though it's only quite subtle, makes a huge difference. Okay, I'm liking that. Now I need to put something nice in the jaw area. So we'll go a bit lighter. Put this in. This is a nice set of fangs that I've just built out of other parts. And what we'll do is we'll do a rolling set, like as if it's like shark teeth coming through. And as it needs them, it grows new ones. There we go. nice visual interest underneath. I don't know why I did that last one, it was a bit ridiculous, so I got rid of it. There we go, that's fine. So a leg. Now what I think I'll do is I'll just do one leg and then I'll repeat it and scale it and move it as needed. So we'll go for a new layer and we'll lay out a leg with some piping first of all. Need a resolution. Single. How does that look? No, still not good enough. But what, one more? Yeah, that will do for the leg. So we're going to come off the body. More wheels and cogs and etc. here. Come off the body twice, I think. And one across the top. In fact, no, we'll start with the middle leg and then it'll be an average, good average. So one here. So one, two. One, two. And then there'll be a joint at the top. Should be one, two. And then first point, second point, and then that will give us enough. So that's good. So we'll get some. Put these joints in now, I think. So one at the top. One on the bottom because it's a good angle. Joint at the top. And then a tinier one here. And a tiny one here. That's good. And now we want some kind of hydraulics in there as well. We'll do that in a moment. Let's try this one. Just to give us a bit more power in the base of the leg. One in here to give more there. I think it needs more of a claw at this end. And it doesn't feel strong enough here. Then I want something like one of these small claws to be the base. So I'm shaking a bit there because it's so small. Just trying to get it to look correct. Not that there is a correct for giant mechanical scorpions. Wanted to go darker, didn't I? So that's better. We'll just bury one of them in there to give us. And that's gone. I don't like that colour now, I've done it. I ended up going more brownish than bluish. No, same again. Let's just double check what we've done wrong there. That must just be the sunlight that's making it look like that, so I won't worry now. I've got quite a warm light in this scene. A few supporting bars in there. And now back to our trusty peeping. Make sure you got a single off. We just have a single leg that we can move wherever we like, which will really give us some visual differences now. So he can now go out here. I'll scale him up a little bit at the back. Duplicate him. This one up in the air a little bit, as if it's got some issues going on. Duplicate him again and roll him forward, so he's got two legs on the ground now. I love the fact that I can relocate these like this. Sure, he looks right in all the angles, which he does. So duplicate, flip, we'll have this one angled right back here. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to change things up a little bit on this side. I think I'm going to try it. Really, actually no, it doesn't work. I was hoping to get away with that to break up the symmetry a little bit more. Doesn't work, so I'll do it in a different way in a moment. Gotta now make it look different. Different angles. So I'll do that with, make sure I'm on each one. A lot more piping on some of them than I do on the others. Fine with that. And then new layer, probably the last layer maybe, I don't know. Resolution, I'm gonna put this guy up here, so single color. And now we need a sting. Yeah. very, very off center, which I like. That's great. And now, back to some piping, I think. A couple of these, first of all. And then smatter it with piping. See lots of wiring just gives you that real sense of mechanical, organic. Emissives. I'm going to think about putting them on a platform of some kind. So, I don't really want to go to town with anything. What I would like is some poison on that sting. And then lots of reds in deep down. I want to do like a lava effect inside him. So let's go new layer. And we'll pick a nice orangey red color. And stay with the spheres. Let's try just specular first of all. Need at least one bit of resolution. And that red's not fiery enough by any stretch. No, and that doesn't work for me. It just looks like dripping blood. So I need to go emissive after all. Just thought I'd try it. So emissive, yeah, that's the one. Strength quite high. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch on to make sure I get this absolutely perfect. I'll switch on line. Eventually, line. And what that means is I want to drip basically. Because then I can paint some, take the line off, I want to paint this all the way through here. And you see now why that, having those holes really helps. You just get to see a little bit of the light coming through. And then, now back to single. Definitely with these kind of eyes, asymmetrical. Just a few cables. A few of the emissive cables. So let's turn him around and have a look at him. So it's only about, I don't know, 40 minutes, something like that. That's pretty much why I'm liking Oculus Medium, because I can knock things out, look how I want them to, even though they're not accurate in any way. But they have some kind of real feel to them. Let's put some lighting on it. And then maybe let's take a few photographs. Now, the thing with the photographs is, with, so bring it close up so you can see all my details in there. As I go away with Oculus Medium, you lose a lot of what you call LODs, so they take away a lot of detail the further away it goes, and you can't really judge your model anymore the further away. So the further away it goes, it just goes, breaks down into bits and pieces. But if you look at it through this internal camera, it's full res, which is cool. So let me make sure you can see that camera. And if you set the settings on it, keep the field of view down, and then attach on. There, stays. So this is really, really cool for setting up photographs. So I can just click him there, make sure he's in frame for everything, and then just take loads of photographs. And now you can see me clicking. That's me clicking this button here. And they're fairly high-res photographs, and that's what I've been using those to paint from. Let's stop him spinning for a moment. Change that lighting around. photographs. I could just move the camera rather than the model if needed. Moving the lighting around now just to see if I can get some nice shadows going on. Bottom lit's always nice. Just move this plane out of the way for now. And then, yeah, that's quite cool. Back and top looks nice. So get the camera out. Let's go. Cool. Makes me a little bit sick, the camera, sometimes, I have to say. Let's move him away over there. Just want to make sure I've got him at every angle. I sometimes lose these models, I should really save at this point, but I'm terrible at doing that. And something that I saw on the forums, the Oculus forums, was to change the lighting, get a 3-point lighting system, so I'll show you what I mean. Find a good hero pose. That's probably. Let's have him like that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one shot, and if I like it and the lighting's right, then I'll change the background colour to a green and it'll be able to key it out. So let's get the light in how I like it. So let's put a rim light on, and the settings are here, and bonk that brightness up there, change the width a little bit. Cool. And now set the camera. Nope, too close to me, so it's the right pose, but it was a bit too close for the camera, so we'll go there. Cool, we'll call it our hero shot. Bring up the camera. And he's good. So, take a photograph there. Just bring the lighting down. Here. Change it to a bluish. Bring the camera back up. Still the same place. Another photograph. And then even maybe one more. We'll do lighting underneath. Same colour lighting, but something from underneath. Bring the camera back up. Another one there. There we go. What I will do is just a little bit of recording of our of the little fella. Let's bring the light back. Couldn't find it then for a second. There we go. Now we can show him off a little bit in Oculus's own recording software. Hoping that I've got him in your field of view. It's very hard showing people things in VR when you're in VR, and quite clearly the thing that you're going to be viewing this on is 2D and just one little tiny section of it, which is quite surely that needs to improve. You can see the LOD is improving there, the levels of detail are getting better as I get closer. Cool, so let's do a quick save of this guy. Quick save. Thing I did say I would do is go into settings, and then background color, let's make a green screen. I know my lighting's good, or good enough for what I want. Let's just take some photographs with that on, and then I'll be able to key that out. Let's see if we've got him from every angle. There we go. Horrible bright screen, get me out of this. Much prefer the dark grey, dark bluey grey for nearly everything. Don't like that bright light at all. Okay, cool. That's our emissive lava scorpion.